week on Randy Jackson Presents America's Best Dance Crew, the Final Four crews blaze the stage alongside Missy Elliott. So Real Crew and Super Crew stayed on top with the most votes and towered over the competition.
Y'all made my video look whack.
That left Fanny Pack and Boogie Bots to face off in a fight for survival. Fanny Pack was out for blood. Boogie Bots couldn't take the heat.
It was bad. It was terrible.
And the bots were terminated. Tonight, we're taking a trip back in time to the 80s. Only three crews remained, and it's anybody's game. They're all heartbeats away from the $100,000 grand prize and the title of America's Best Dance Crew. And first of all, we would like to thank the Teen Choice Awards for crowning us the best dance show on television. We are down to three crews all competing to be America's Best Dance Crew. So let's bring them out here. The Retro Squad from Hollywood, Fanny Pack. Houston Smooth and Sexy, So Real Crew. Vegas Super B-Boy Super Crew. These three crews have fought their way through the season, leaving all the other crews in their wake. You at home voted, and we're going to reveal the results and the number one vote getter later in the show. But first, it's time to head back to the decade when hip-hop and breakdancing blew up, the 1980s. Each crew has to perform twice tonight to our 80s-themed challenges. So, let's jump right into their first test, the Groove Step Challenge. Each team picked a party dance move from the 80s, and then we gave them an additional physical challenge. Super Crew's up first. So let's see what happened when Layla Kaylee broke it down for our crews.
This week is going to be totally rad because we're traveling back to the 80s for a show with not one, but two dance challenges. First up, the Groove Step Challenge. We've created a DVD compilation of some of the most memorable party dances of the 80s. And your challenge will be to build a routine featuring these retro steps. But it won't be easy because you will also be given a tricky physical task to complete.
Last week, Super Crew finally convinced JC that they deserve to be in the competition.
That was an amazing performance.
Can they convince America that they deserve to win?
Super Crew, you guys must perform one of your 80s moves with only 4 feet on the floor.
Oh! 80s challenge, guys, let's do this!
Yeah!
Oh, that's it!
Automatically, we knew that that was one of the dances that we wanted to do. Anytime it comes on in the club, you automatically know the Humpty dance.
But with 4 feet, it puts a whole completely different spin on it.
How are we gonna do this dance with only 4 feet?
We tried to get up on top of each other so that we can get as many feet off the ground as possible, but it's hard because you also have to do the dance while you're in that formation.
This is difficult.
One, two, three, go.
There's only three crews left. We have to win this.
This is what we were training 8 years for. This moment right here.
If we don't take this serious now, then we could go home.
Can they do the Humpty Hump with only 4 feet on the floor? Performing to an 80s master mix, here is Super Crew.
Come on, baby, tell me what's the word. Now, when I
you, Super Crew. Gotta check in with our judges. Mr. Shane Sparks, what you think? How'd we start it off?
Crazy. Give it up for Super Crew. Yo, I never thought I'd see the day when I see Super Crew doing the WAP, the Running Man, y'all doing the Humpty Dance. Y'all did it four different ways. Crazy. And the thing that was crazy is when you did the one hand hops on your boy's chest. That's out of here. That's out of here. Way to start the show, Super Crew.
La mama.
Yo, this crew is crazy. And the reason why I respect you guys so much is because you live up to your name. This is definitely a super crew. Your stunts is amazing. I want to go into a slow-mo right now. When you all like went into flares, it was a ripple of flares that went across the stage. And then Ronnie, he continued. This, I'm just going to direct y'all through this one. Here's the ripples. And then you have Ronnie. He continues to do the flares, and he comes and he threads his team up, and everybody comes into like a B-boy stance on their knee, and then he hits a freeze. This crew is amazing. I love y'all.
JC.
Yeah,
crazy.
I mean, you guys realize what show this is. You realize it's down to the final three because you're going all out, and you've showed us a little bit of everything in this performance. You showed us the choreography, and you used it with the 80s choreography. You guys have given us stunts. You guys have given us a lot of creativity because the challenge was to get onto 4 feet. Now, you guys have 12 feet up there, obviously. You have 6 guys, 12 feet, and we need to get down to 4. And you guys made, like, Humpty Towers. Like, so it was fun to watch. It was a really enjoyable performance, and it was a great way to start the show.
Humpty Dance taking us back. All right. Gonna find out the results of America's Vote later on, and if Super Crew survives the night, you'll have your chance to vote for him at the end of the show. Thank you, Super Crew. When we come back, So Real Crew's gonna bring back some totally awesome 80s action, and later, gonna reveal which two powerhouse crews will go head-to-head in the biggest battle yet. This is America's Best Dance Crew. Rashida blowing out the speakers. I'm Mario Lopez, and welcome back to America's Best Dance Crew, where we're kicking it old school to hits from the 80s. Each crew is performing twice tonight with the entire game on the line. We just saw Super Crew do the Humpty Dance, and now So Real Crew is up next. Let's see how this fluid crew got ready for the Groove Step Challenge.
So Real Crew has glided their way into the top three, and America's Vote has kept them off the chopping block.
I just want to congratulate y'all for still being in the top and never reaching the bottom.
For your physical challenge, your crew will have to start a chain reaction during your routine.
We didn't know exactly what to do for the chain reaction, so we tried a lot of things.
It's the kid in play. That would be perfect for our chain reaction.
The kid in play is perfect because once one person does it, everyone wants to get in on it. We want to make sure that we pay tribute to the 80s, but we really want to put our flavor into it.
Pretty hard, man.
Well, they set off the chain reaction and bring kid in play up to date. Performing to an 80s master mix, this is So Real Crew.
I think that you guys definitely had a lot of fun tonight. Your costumes definitely brought the theme. Everybody knows 80s when they see it, and you guys brought that tonight. Your thing was to bring the kid in play, and you was very creative with it. I had fun. I expect I, I,
will say that I did expect more out of you guys, but you had a lot of fun. You had a lot of fun up here.
JC.
What's more fun than watching The Running Man in full blast? It was fun. The opening was great. And you guys just didn't hold it in place. It was a nice transition. You guys moved lines while you were doing it, so you used it well. Brian and Pat, you guys are doing butterfly flips, you know, with each other. That was fun. I will say the one part, Andrew, I hate to single you out, but you were a little off at the hand-to-mouth choreography. You got a little loose. Well, easy. Come on, man. You weren't quite as tight as the rest of the guys, you know, in your crew. But, you know, overall, it was a good performance.
Shane.
I feel the same way. Like, I feel y'all did the moves, but y'all didn't have that energy that we used to have back in the days when we used to do those dances. Like, so I like what y'all did. The best part about it was when Pat and Brian did the flares, and then he goes into turtles. Right here. The reason I like this so much because the timing on it had to be, like, perfect. Because if he'd have landed on me, it'd have been over.
That's nice.
Like, that was beautiful.
That's nice.
I just wish y'all could have had a little more energy. Like JC said, the beginning was tight, but it started dying down a little bit, and it started looking like y'all were just trying to put stuff in to make the task happen. That's just my take on it, you know what I mean?
Okay. Well, we're going to reveal the results of your vote in just a moment, and if So Real Crew stays in the game, you're going to be able to vote for them at the end of the night. Thank you, So Real Crew. When we come back, Fanny Pack will be paying tribute to the decade that gave them their inspiration. And we are moments away from finding out which crews will face elimination. That's all coming up on America's Best Dance Crew. We are back on America's Best Dance Crew, and we are reliving the decade that gave birth to MTV, the 1980s. Two crews have already rocked out to party dances, and now it's time for Fanny Pack to show us how radical they can be. Let's see what happened when they found out they were heading back to the 80s. Last week, Fanny Pack found themselves in the bottom two, but it didn't stop them from bringing the audience to their feet. This is our first standing ovation from the judges.
Even though our performance went so well last week, we cannot let ourselves get comfortable.
Fanny Pack, at some point during your routine, you'll have to dance horizontally.
What?
The fanny pack is the 80s. And 80s dance moves are big in your face.
Oh my God, the Vanilla Ice, look at that.
So the Vanilla Ice is normally this way, and fanny pack has to do it this way.
And the hardest part of the move is trying to do the hop hop turn horizontally because you gotta find gravity.
Can they handle Vanilla Ice's moves from a different angle? Performing to an 80s master mix, here is Fanny Pack. Clever, but the shout out to mom.
That's hot.
What's up?
That's hot.
JC, what do you think?
You know what? Yeah, word to your mother, kids. That's a great, great thing you guys just did. Say hi to all the moms out there. You guys have a secret weapon in your group, and I think it's Glenda, because, you know, honey, again, you're a beautiful story. You know, you come from living in your car. I know you want this. I know you want this bad. You're pushing yourself because you have showed up and become the most athletic female of the season.
Mm-hmm.
You have. You know, because this dance competition is about being athletic. It's about being creative. It's about being talented. It's about being tight. And you've showed something athletic. I'm going to go into it right now with a slow-mo. Honey, you're doing scissor kicks and hand hops at the same time. This is dope to see a girl do. Like, there's... in every other crew, it would be a guy. It's a girl. Wonderful job.
Shane, you know what? At the beginning of the show, everybody was like, who do you think is going to win? And I said, Fanny Pack. And everybody looked at me like I was crazy. And now we're down to the top three. And look at y'all right now. Every show, y'all have ripped. Y'all have come to dance. Y'all have come to play ball every night. And I give y'all so much props and so much respect for that. Y'all task was to do something horizontally for Ice Ice Baby. Y'all drop down on the floor and y'all go scoot back and then do the dance. How cold was that? And then we got Bill playing Vanilla Ice. It was just crazy, and y'all deserve to be right here where y'all are, and I just give y'all a big applause for that. Good job.
Lil Mama.
In the package, Linda said Fanny Pack is the 80s. And when you guys came out to perform, I watched you and I thought about that. Are they the 80s or are they not? And you guys lived up to it as you do every week. You are so 80s. Y'all brought that energy out. Y'all made us excited throughout y'all whole performance. One of the most memorable pieces was the diagonal like snake. It was so neat. And you guys take so much time out to perfect yourself. And I really appreciate this group and the competition. Keep doing y'all thing.
Yep. Okay, well, Fanny Pack makes the cut tonight. We're gonna give you the numbers to vote for them at the end of the show. Thank you very much, Fanny Pack. All right, there's a whole second round of performances still to come, and after the break, we're going to reveal the results of your vote and tell you for the first time this entire season which crew got the most votes. The game is heating up. America's Best Dance Crew. Welcome back to America's Best Dance Crew. I'm Mario Lopez, and I'm joined on stage by the remaining three crews. Last week, America voted. And we're about to reveal for the first time this season which crew captured the most votes. That crew will avoid elimination and lock down a spot on the finale. The other two crews will battle for the last remaining spot in the championship, and one of them will be going home tonight. It's time to reveal the results. Pack. On the first show, your 80s style seemed like a gimmick, and you quickly found yourselves in the bottom two facing elimination. But your crew has proven itself time and time again with groundbreaking choices and one-of-a-kind routines. Last week, you fought for your lives, overpowered the competition, and got a standing ovation from all three judges and Missy Elliott. Super Crew. You've received the highest praise from the judges of any team, but the voters have made you battle for survival more than once. When the judges challenged you on your choreography, you stayed true to yourselves and delivered stunts and b-boy floor work to silence the critics. You've teetered on the edge of elimination, but have yet to fall off. And last week, you rebounded up into the top two crews. So Real Crew. Your crew has never been in the bottom two, but even though you've stayed strong with the voters, the judges have come down on your crew more than once for not having enough difficulty in your routines. In fact, last week, Shane and JC butted heads over it. Will your crew pull off a perfect season without ever being in the bottom two? The first crew that will be up for elimination and have to battle for their lives tonight is... Fanny Pack. Sorry guys, but unfortunately you're back in the line of fire and this could be your last night on our stage. That means Super Crew and So Real Crew, one of you got the highest vote total and will definitely compete in the championships. The other will face off against Fanny Pack in a fight for survival. The crew that is guaranteed a shot at the title of America's Best Dance Crew is... So Real Crew. Congratulations, guys. You are America's number one vote getter right at this moment, and you've clinched a spot in the finals. That means Super Crew, guys have to head into battle again. And of course, this could be your final curtain call. All right, So Real Crew can celebrate by kicking off the second 80s throwback of the night, the Dance Movie Challenge.
For your second performance this week, you will be taking on the Dance Movie Challenge. Yeah. You will each be given a classic dance scene from an iconic 80s movie which you'll use to inspire your routine. But you're not copying it, you're updating it. You must add your own modern spin to one of these groundbreaking movies. So Real Crew, here is your dance movie scene.
Breaking.
This week we're paying tribute to the legendary movie Breakin'.
The dancers in this movie are like legends of breakdancing.
The scene with Turbo and the broom, it was just one of the most memorable scenes of the movie. Turbo's animation is on point. It's really a lot of contracting and control with your muscles. If you're not clean, it's gonna look horrible.
That was really ugly.
Check out that knee drop.
Today's rehearsal was kind of rough.
I don't know how we're gonna do it, but we gotta push harder.
Yeah! And they nail the classic moves and go for a clean sweep. Performing to the iconic electro beats from Breakin', here is So Real Crew.
Judges, how'd they do the second time around, Shane?
I don't think y'all know that is my favorite movie, favorite song, favorite scene in that movie. Y'all picked the perfect person and the perfect movie to be inspired by. The broom stuff was out of here. The mirror stuff was out of here. The knee drop was beautiful. What y'all wearing, how y'all thought right now for this particular episode was so perfect because it just put y'all on a whole nother level in my mind. And y'all needed to go there today. I appreciate that.
Lil Mama.
I actually love the fact that you guys got back into character. Your performance earlier, it didn't really impress me. But just now, y'all proved to everybody why y'all was voted in the top. That performance was excellent. Brian in the package said he wanted the illusion to look like snapshots, and you guys gave us that. As soon as you came from behind the mirrors, everything was tight and it looked like a picture. I could take each step and make it a photograph. I love that. You guys, congratulations. For sure.
JC.
This routine, I have to say, was very, very clean. It looked really good. You guys used the mirrors. This was a very clever idea, and you guys ended up making a hand illusion. I mean, it looks like 50,000 hands are flying around. It's a smart idea. Nice work. I don't know if I loved the solos, but the broom trick was good. I know I'm gonna hear it again. I don't know if it was my favorite, but it was good.
Okay, well, if you want So Real Crew to win the whole competition, voting opens at the end of the show. We're going to give you the numbers in just a bit. Thank you, So Real Crew. Let's check in with Layla Kaylee, who's back in the crew garage. Layla?
Thank you, Mario. I am here with Super Crew and Fanny Pack, two of the judges' favorite crews, but unfortunately, one of them will be leaving us tonight. Now, Dunok, this is Super Crew's third time up for elimination. How will you overcome the odds tonight?
Right now, I'm so overwhelmed, and I love Fanny Pack. And yo, this shouldn't be, but it is. So we're gonna give you guys a show. We're gonna do our thing. We love you.
Well, everyone out there loves you guys too. Now, Fanny Pack, Tiffany, it's do or die time right now. How much pressure are you feeling?
I mean, the pressure is on right now, but I have absolutely nothing but faith in my crew. We came from the bottom. Nobody won us here at the beginning. America stood by us this whole time. We're gonna go out there and do what we have to do. We have nothing but love for Super Crew. Fanny Pack and Super Crew is gonna give you a show right now.
But I got love for the both of you, and I'm so proud of you both. Best of luck, okay? Now, when we come back, these two crews go full out for the last remaining spot in the finals. One crew will rise, the other's banners and dreams will come crashing down. This is Randy Jackson Presents... What is it?
America's Best Dance Crew!
That's right.
America's Best Dance Crew is back, and these two crews, Super Crew and Fanny Pack, are about to give the highest stakes performances of their lives. There's only room for one more team to join So Real Crew in the final two, and the other crew will see their incredible journey come to an end tonight. Oh, we flipped a coin backstage, and Super Crew is up first. Let's see how these B-Boys went back in the day for the Dance Movie Challenge.
Super Crew, here is your dance movie scene.
Footloose. My first impressions of the movie Footloose is wild and crazy.
Let's dance!
That's the move we need to do right there.
A little heel-toe shuffle.
When you see that heel-toe shuffle, you instantly know it's Footloose.
Now we got the legs, let's try to get the arms.
One of the biggest challenges, it wasn't exactly the step itself. It's just more putting a spin on it and making it work for us.
We can do it one leg.
This is our last chance to get in the top two, so this show can either make us or break us.
Can they put their own spin on the heel-toe shuffle without spinning out of control? In a make-or-break performance to a remix of the film's title track, Footloose, here is Super Crew. Swinging, and now it's Fanny Pack's turn to march in a battle. They came together because of the 80s, but now the 80s could be the last stop. Let's see how they prepared for the action in the dance movie challenge.
Fanny Pack, here is your dance movie scene. Yes. Yes.
Flash Dance and Fanny Pack, what better combo could you put together?
A yes, gang! Super duper!
We felt right at home with all the leaps and head whips and layouts.
One of the most iconic moves is the punch step into the pirouette turns.
I definitely can't do what he just did. Today I actually turned into Teach Bill How to Do a Pirouette Day. She's teasing me because I can't do pirouettes. The pressure is really on me because I really need to step up to their level. Don't lie, if I suck, just say I suck.
Then Bo punch step into pirouettes and help his crew not get punched out. With their future in their hands, performing to a remix of Maniac from Flashdance, this is Fanny Pack. Center stage, and these two crews have worked so very hard to be here tonight, but only one of them can move on, and it is time to find out what the judges think. Shane, please give me your thoughts on Super Crew.
Super Crew, just know this, no matter what happens after tonight, after this show is over, y'all totally represented for B-boys, for breakdancers.
All around the world. Y'all
totally taking B-boys, like, we was always in the back burner. It was always like, whatever, whatever, whatever. That would never be said again. And y'all just showed the world what y'all all about. And I appreciate that. Y'all piece was beautiful. It was very creative. But the thing that was so cold is y'all, this little B-boy set that y'all did. Can I go into a slow-mo really quick just so everybody can see? They did this assisted flip right here. Do Not and RJ. Check it out. Slide on the knee. The famous knee slide. And then we got Do Not doing a butterfly kick off of his back. Like y'all got to be very proud of yourself because y'all execution is always almost perfect. You know what I mean? Great job tonight, and I wish y'all the best of luck.
Lil' Mama, talk to me about Fanny Pack, please.
10, 10, 10, shabam. That was crazy. Let me tell you, this was creative, theatrical, humorous, and an entertaining performance from beginning to end. I want to get into a slow-mo when Carol, like, did her solo, and she came to the table, and she was dancing. It was a very rememberable piece from the movie Flashdance. It was on point, and you guys totally stayed focused. I have to say, look at Shay smacking her booty.
Phil, get your eyes off her booty,
but
man.
You guys are so creative. And let me say that you take your time. I could tell that this is a group in rehearsal that's like, no, it's no way we're going to just sit there that we're the judges. You know what I mean? We're going to still do things. You took the clipboards and you used them as props, used them very well. You guys came out here, you partnered up with your teams and created little midgets and was like dancing. You didn't do the classical midget where you take a big t-shirt and throw it over your legs and do anything. You guys hit choreography that you would hit standing up alone. And I respect that.
Jesse, tell us how you felt about both these stellar crews.
Well, you know, I'm just like, I'm scratching my head. I have to be honest with you right now, because if you think that So Real Crew outdanced these two crews tonight, I don't buy it. I said it.
No.
I said it.
I disagree.
I said it.
I disagree.
Well, we can agree to disagree. Because I have to be honest with you. I'm going to tell you right now, nobody on this show is more athletic than the Super Crew right here. Who's going to be more creative than Fanny Pack? Who's going to be more creative? We're talking about going above and beyond because we want to see the best. And I have to say, you guys have given us your best, and I am thankful. I got a front row seat, and I appreciate what you have done for us. Now, Super Crew, your task was, you know, to be Kevin Bacon, and it was the heel turn move. And I'm going to go into a slow-mo real quick because you guys did it, again, in an interesting way. You recreated it by giving us levels. You gave us low, and you gave us high with the heel toe thing. You blessed us with your athletic ability, your creativity, and I enjoyed you guys very much. Now I'm going to go into Fanny Pack. You guys are so wildly entertaining, and I want to talk about the technique that you guys showed us. You showed us something else. I know, Bo, you had never done, you know, pirouettes before, and you're doing like the punch stop, and you hit a double pirouette, and you have to spot. It takes time to learn that. You know, the ladies, you're doing the layouts. Nice work. You guys showed us technique, and that's something that the other groups didn't quite show us, a classical technique, and it was nice to see. You know, the judges thing was obviously funny. The bow tie, I caught a lot of crap for that. Funny. I've enjoyed watching you guys. Every time you take the stage, I get excited. It was a wonderful show tonight. This is the hardest decision that we are going to have to make to date. This is the hardest decision.
Yep. Okay, well, during the break, the judges are going to huddle up and have to make that decision based, of course, on Super Crew and Fanny Pack's performances tonight. Both crews have dazzled us all season long, but the judges can choose only one to send into the finals. The other will leave our stage forever. ABDC, stay locked. Welcome back to America's Best Dance Crew. The time has come. These two crews, Supercrew and Fanny Pack just performed for their lives. Judges can save only one. The other crew's dream ends tonight. Supercrew, Shane said that you're represented for breakdancers worldwide, and now b-boying will never be on the back burner again. JC said that there's nobody more athletic than your crew, and you blessed us with all your abilities. Fanny Pack. Well, Mama said you were incredible and entertaining from beginning to end. JC said you showed amazing technique, and there's no one as creative as you guys. He went on to add that both crews left them at a loss for words, and this is the hardest decision the judges have had to make to date. The crew that will be competing next week and is one step away from the title of America's Best Dance Crew is... Congratulations, Super Crew. We're moving on to the finals, and we're going to see you next week. Emotional time for you all and for a lot of people here in the audience. I gotta tell you, each week you were so clever, you were so creative, you showed such skill and technique, and you guys showed such heart and passion. I don't think anybody will ever forget Fanny Pack. Ever. You know, and you made it this far, all the way to the end, but unfortunately for us tonight we have to say goodbye, and we're really, really sorry to see you go. Is there anything that you'd like to say?
I am completely and utterly thankful for everyone. For everyone. This whole thing was the best experience of our lives. I'm so proud of my crew. And all I can really say is, America, vote completely right next week. Completely right.
Well, let's take a look back at your remarkable journey here on America's Best Dance Crew, guys.
This experience is something I'll remember forever. It's been such a blast.
You guys are coming to the live audition.
Y'all just tore it down. Seriously.
Fanny Pack doesn't fit any mold, but we're proud of it.
You guys are artists, and I respect that a lot.
America has finally embraced MV Fanny Pack.
This is our first standing ovation from the judges.
In the beginning, we were kind of the underdogs, but I'm really proud of myself and my crew for what we've accomplished.
2 months ago, I was living out of my car. This week, I'm performing on national television. It's unbelievable.
Fanny Pack. Again, we want to thank you so much. As you're huddling up. Felt left out of the group hug. Thank you. Thank you so much, you guys, for all your dedication, all your hard work. It was amazing. And now, of course, it's time to take your final walk off our stage. And as you do, your banner must fall. remain, but only one will win the $100,000 grand prize and be crowned America's Best Dance Crew. Will it be Super Crew or So Real Crew? It all depends on you, so you gotta vote. We're keeping the lines open all week long, so you have plenty of time to make your voice heard. I'm gonna give you the numbers to vote while we look back at tonight's performances. Judges say Super Crew, but if you want them to win the ultimate prize, you have to vote for them by calling 1-877-RJ-CREW-2 or text 2 to the number 22444. So Real Crew avoided the bottom two all season. If you want to keep them in the top spot, vote for them by calling 1-877-RJ-CREW-1 or text 1 to the number 22444. And remember, standard rates apply. Voting brought to you by the new AT&T Your World Delivered. Calls are toll-free from landlines, and you can also vote online at dancecrew.mtv.com. Voting starts right now. Remember, we're keeping lines open all week long, so you can choose which crew you want to crown America's Best Dance Crew. Next week, it's the showdown, where our final two crews will put their all-around dance ability to the test in a knockdown, drag-em-out fight, and then it's on to the live finale on August 21st. I'm Mario Lopez. Good night. This Saturday, August 9th at 11 a.m. Eastern to catch America's Best Dance Crew Inside the Moves, a special encore of tonight's show with our crew's commentary right here on MTV.